What's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Hustle at Midnight. Before we get into it today, I did just want to give a shout out to Above Detour or Above Detour, depending on how you want to pronounce it, for the awesome intro music, custom intro music that was refined to the T. I really appreciate it, man. So thank you for writing that out and really, you know, getting that going, because it's an awesome intro and I have a lot of fun, weaving it into the videos. So today we are going to talk about what would happen after me meeting Josh. And one of the most helpful things was essentially not just his mentorship, but also being introduced to the group that would later become Developer Direction, right? Which was just a conglomeration of different developers, already professional developers, young students wanting to become developers, and just essentially a network of people who already worked in the industry. You could go and ask somebody who's already professionally employed as an engineer about their job, how they got into the market. So it was informationally rich, right? So that in and of itself, if you guys have seen my prior videos, was very, very helpful, because I had essentially acquired two of the most important things in a self-taught individual's journey, which is a mentor and a group, right? And that would prove to be a massive asset and a massive tool for me in the coming months as I was dealt with some of the most difficult obstacles that I had ever been, not just in my journey to become a software engineer, but also just in my life in general, right? And one of the first obstacles that came was a technical one, right? So Josh had put me to work in essentially constructing an MVC application, which is a design pattern that is an abbreviation for a model view controller back into front end application that essentially is just a common way that enterprise based applications are constructed. And I had never, confronted myself with C#, a design pattern, object oriented programming. All of those things were very, very new to me. So it was very, very, very difficult for me on the initial run to just understand what was going on. I mean, I remember just trying to install attempting to install Visual Studio in my MacBook, in my local machine, had become just so stressful for me. It was not adapted. The Visual Studio in and of itself is not natively, essentially, it's not built to natively interact with Mac. So they have a Mac version of it, but it is just kind of a watered down version of the IDE, which is an integrated development environment. So when I installed it into my computer, some of the things that I needed to execute in order to correctly build the MVC application, I was limited by just some of the configurations from the way that the Visual Studio came out of the box, right? So without getting too technical here, I would then come to back to Josh and tell him, hey man, look, Visual Studio is just kind of a pain in the butt to work with on Mac. So what we ended up deciding to do is to install a virtual machine in my computer so that we can work through Visual Studio and actually build out the application. Now, just the installation process was nerve-wracking. I'd never had to, install a virtual machine into my computer. And to make it simple for you guys, all that means is that I installed essentially another computer within my computer so that I could run a program that would allow me to build an application, right? So it was a bit of a headache to go through that process when I was essentially, just a little hatchling in this new world of code. And through his help, we ended up being able to get it installed, and I went ahead and started to build the application. Now, that's where I was at from a coding standpoint, consistently learning new things, just getting inherently comfortable with the design pattern, learning, things that are really important related to object-oriented programming, like inheritance, also being able to understand how data flows from the back end to the front end. All of those things were new concepts to me, and toward the end of this particular application, application would be the first eureka moment that I would have with programming, where I finally where I would finally feel that I could actually code, right? And it took quite a while. I mean, it was the 6 months of coding prior to this, and then me meeting my mentor, who then gave me a application to build that would lead me to finally being able to learn how to actually, you know, have that eureka moment of saying, hey, look, I could actually code. And if you guys have seen my videos prior to this, what that actually means is that Josh had essentially set up a situation in which I would have to generate original code based off what I had learned in terms of constructing that specific application. And that led to me being able to essentially finally being able to work with the ideas that I had learned and then build something new with it based off of that design pattern, based off of that technology, based off of that IDE, right? Josh can essentially set that play up so that I can finally have that moment of, oh man, I can code now, because I was able to take what I learned and take it to a new place, like I always tell you guys, right? So, you know, and if you want to get even more simple than that, I took the literal code that I learned and built new code in front of it that was not taught in the tutorial. And that's when things started to roll. So I finally got over my tutorial hell. You know, I finally felt like I was in a space where I was like, okay, cool. Like, this is the first time that I've generated some code that wasn't all just completely copied from a tutorial. And that was amazing. I think that was a really amazing space for me to be in. From a strategic standpoint, we started to aim at going for a company that essentially worked at positioning new developers with contracting new developers with a third party. So essentially there would be like a middleman that would, you know, they would train you and teach you how to code, and then they would contract you out to somebody who needed developers. But then the caveat is that you would be in debt to the company that trained you and then that contracted you out. So you'd be working for that company while you're employed for a third party, right? And then at the end of that contract, the third party can decide to buy your contract out, or you could stay, or you could go back to the original company that trained you, right? The caveat is that you were in debt to the company that trained you, and you would have to pay an X amount of money to them to be completely released of your affiliation with them, right? To be quite frank, it was a form of indentured servitude. However, the benefit that they sold you on is that if you have no experience, they could essentially put you in a position where you could get professional experience. And at the time, we didn't really know my skill level. I didn't really know my skill level. So it seemed like a pretty viable option to me to say, hey, look, well, maybe I have to exchange some of my freedom in order to get into this industry. And it was a plan that at the time I was willing to go through, and it was a plan at the time that I was willing to go through. In the back of my head, I always thought, if I could get employed by myself, then that's something that I'd also run with, you know, because then I would avoid having to owe anybody money for anything, you know, and I could just start generating income myself in the industry. So that was what was happening, both from a technical standpoint and then a strategic standpoint. However, the thing that I think a lot of people do not talk about when it comes to learning to code, and in particular to being self-taught, is that life doesn't stop happening while you're learning to code, right? And in any juncture, really. I mean, even if you go through a boot camp, you still have to go through life. Rent is still due at the end of the month. Your bills still have to be paid. And one of the things that I mentioned in the last video is that work was starting to slow at the barback job, right? So I was starting to run out of money. I was studying a lot more. I was learning how to code a lot more, but I was making a lot less money. So work had slowed down. I was learning to code quite a bit. And overall, my financial picture was that I was running out of money, essentially. Now, this was exacerbated by a couple things. I had made an investment in buying a new MacBook, so I had upgraded from the Chromebook. And the other thing that exacerbated this financial issue was that I had gone in a car accident. Now, I had gone in a car accident on my own, where I had essentially wrecked the control arm of the front of my vehicle exiting from a freeway out in Los Angeles, right? Which was actually pretty scary. And I'm I'm very thankful that I came out of that, you know, unscathed, but it was fairly dangerous, you know, coming out, you know, exiting the freeway at a high speed and then essentially colliding against a curb that wrecked the front left side of my car. Not the aesthetic front end of the car, but the control arm that holds the wheel in its place and moves it around, right? So I had wrecked that, and that ended up coming, you know, that ended up being a charge that I was not accounting for the month in which that happened, right? This is somewhere in January 2020. Right. So I quickly realized that I was heading into a critical moment in my journey where I was running out of money. I was hit with an emergency situation. I had to come back to the drawing table and really put into perspective how I was going to make it through these next 6 months. Right. And I think one of the biggest challenges that I knew I was going to head into was the practicality of continuing to study to code. So being relentless on that front, while then realizing that I had to make the financial adjustments of quite simply getting another job and what would end up being getting two more jobs. And that was the beginning of the end of my time in Los Angeles. So that was it for today. I did also just want to give a shout out to Developer Direction has a new blockchain course. Make sure to take advantage of this opportunity. The market is hot for blockchain developers. This technology is only going to continue to advance and become increasingly more important to humanity in general. So make sure to take this opportunity to jump in on that ride and really be a part of the future. Enrollment closes on December 12th. Do not miss the blockchain train and jump on in at developerdirection.com. But that was it. I appreciate you guys. I will catch you next time. Peace.